today we're with Mr. Mahmoud Skaf, who is the general manager of the Ritz-Carlton Kuala Lumpur, as well as the general manager of the JW Marriott Kuala Lumpur. That's a lot of work you have on your hands there, Mr. Skaf.
Thank you.
Now, being Ritz-Carlton, let's concentrate today on the Ritz-Carlton property. It's one of the most famous and one of the most luxurious hotel companies in the world. When you have such an established hotel as this one is in Kuala Lumpur, how do you manage to maintain its relevance when there are so many new hotels coming online in the city?
Well, Ritz-Carlton actually, maybe in products, if you look to our products, is we have the consistency and the need for all our clients. However, we maintain our branding with service. Our gold standard, actually, and our ladies and gentlemen, the service provided for our client is expected. So we keep our standards so high with service.
Right. And in terms of the markets that you have here at the hotel, which are your top five markets for Kuala Lumpur? And how do you see that changing, for example, as we move forward over the next couple of years?
The top market, I could say to you, here in Asia, we have Singapore, we have Indonesia also, we have Europe, we have United States. But the next 2-3 years, I think we're going to see increasing of the Chinese market. Chinese start to travel a lot to Malaysia for MICE business.
Right. Now, with the Chinese market, obviously we have Taiwan, Hong Kong, and mainland China as well. Language can be an issue at times. How do you address that? Because obviously the Chinese market, they do like to be able to speak in their own language, Mandarin, or one of the local dialects. How do you address that here at the hotel?
That's why Malaysia, actually, if you look to Malaysia, we are the best destination for all nationality. Chinese come here, they find their food, they find the language. We have all our staff here who's Chinese, speak Mandarin, Cantonese, anything you want.
Right. And in terms of other markets, the Middle East market is becoming very popular for the Kuala Lumpur and also Malaysia as a whole. Which markets in the Middle East are you targeting? And in terms of numbers, what sort of percentage would they represent?
It's tragedy what you see going on now in Middle East. But in same time, that's what benefit us as Malaysian. Malaysia as a country really welcome all kind of Middle Eastern. Middle Eastern love to come to Malaysia because of food, shopping, and most of the country who come here, the Gulf country. You look UAE, Qatar, Bahrain, Saudi Arabia, and we used to see it seasonally, July, August, when school closed. Now around the year, you'll see business from Middle East coming and continue to growth.
Right. The Marriott has a very good name in the Middle East. It has some amazing properties. The Ritz-Carlton in Dubai is absolutely outstanding. Of those particular markets, do you concentrate on any particular markets? You mentioned quite a few in the GCC and some in the UAE and what have you. Which markets in particular are you targeting?
Mostly our target, when you see us, we exist every year. I go myself to the ATM in Dubai. So we concentrate a lot in the Gulf, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, UAE. It's big market for us.
Right. With the Chinese market and the Middle Eastern markets, how do the demands of those travelers differ?
I think it's the timing different between these two markets. The Chinese, you start to see the Chinese now, in the end of the year and throughout maybe March and April, because of all the holiday the Chinese celebrate. For Middle East, now throughout the year. However, the big traveler is in summertime when the school's out. And as you know, Middle East in summertime is really hot.
Oh, very hot indeed. Now, in terms of the demographics of the guests that you have here, are they mainly business or are they also leisure travelers?
We have about 60% business and 40% leisure.
Right. And is that something you're trying to increase on one side or the other? And if so, how are you doing that?
We try actually to increase in business clientele because Malaysia starts to welcome all different businesses because of cost-wise and location. So we're concentrating more in MICE business. MICE business was coming really from China.
Right. And in terms of the MICE facilities that you have here at the hotel, because obviously the hotel itself is a beautiful property, and the rooms are probably some of the largest that you have in Kuala Lumpur. But in terms of MICE facilities, what is it that you're offering those people that you're targeting?
If you believe it or not, when I travel and talk about MICE, between the Ritz-Carlton and JW Marriott, we own 56 different meeting rooms. So we can host all kind of MICE from 1,000 customers to a 15 customer.
Right. And how much of the MICE business, because a lot of people neglect the domestic market, how much of the MICE business is domestic in Malaysia compared to international MICE market that you're looking for?
MICE business in Malaysia, 80% from outside, 20% local.
Right, okay. And in terms of the weekend traffic, because Ritz-Carlton throughout the world, especially in major cities, one of the issues they have is trying to fill the rooms at the weekend. How do you manage to be able to do that?
True. Most of our business in the weekend slow in the city like KL, especially with a leisure also client, they travel in the weekend to the seaside. But here, the blessing for our hotel, Ritz-Carlton and the Marriott, is the location. So we get a lot of local also from outside to come to KL, and they love to stay with us because of our location.
Right. Now recently, the Kuala Lumpur was voted as one of the top shopping destinations in the world.
Correct.
You have one of the most amazing shopping malls just moments away, just seconds away from the hotel, the JW and the Ritz-Carlton. How has the opening of the pavilion actually helped your business?
I believe the pavilion increase about 30% of our business in this hotel, in Ritz-Carlton and the Marriott. And also don't forget the credit goes to the owner of the hotel. It's big company, YTL. YTL is big part of the improvement in this street.
Right. In terms of the property, the Ritz-Carlton itself, you have 365 rooms in total. How have you separated and split up the rooms in terms of the room categories that you have, and how do they differ, please?
We have in the Ritz-Carlton, in the main building, 251 rooms. This room divided, our biggest selling room is the Executive Deluxe, where really for business traveler, it's spacious, it's big, it's enough room to work. But also don't forget we have the apartments, which is 2 and 3 bedrooms apartment, which is catered mostly to family and Middle Eastern leisure group and all this stuff. We have 115 apartments.
Right, and I also believe you have some very, very special, in fact, we're sat in one of your very special suites. Could you tell us a little bit about the suites that you have here at the hotel?
We have a beautiful suite. If you look around you, it's a triple floor, actually, 3 floors, not duplex. We can't say duplex. We have a swimming pool in each suite in the roof. And this one is like really 5 bedrooms and 4 bedrooms. It's caters to most delegate royalty and the high-end clientele.
Right. Now, in terms of Ritz-Carlton, it is a classic elegance, generally, in terms of the design that you have in the rooms. And sometimes some hotel companies are very slow when it comes to technology. What are your personal thoughts on technology such as 24-hour stays where you can check in at 6, check out at 6, self-service check-in, those sort of things? What are your thoughts on such technology?
Well, when we come to Ritz-Carlton, I believe self-service does not exist. I don't think it will happen one day in the Ritz-Carlton. Why? Because really our slogan, our gold standard, concentrate in service. We like to butler, we like to service every client we have. This hotel, and specifically here in Kuala Lumpur, we have butler service 24 hours for all clients, not only suite band. Any client who stays in the Ritz-Carlton will get 24-hour butler service.
Right. I'd just like to ask you about the butler service, because it is something that the Ritz-Carlton is very proud of. And there's a few other hotel companies as well where their top tier has butlers as well. How many of your guests actually make full use of the butler? Because I know when I'm traveling on business, the last thing I want is somebody going through my luggage. But then again, I'm not possibly in that category where I'm used to such things. What percentage of your guests actually makes full use of the butler service?
Actually, in the beginning, people like you and me used to hesitate to have the butler and bag their luggage. But when they do it, we get used to it, we spoiled. Actually, 80% of our customers, they come to the hotel because the name Ritz-Carlton and also the butler service.
Right. In terms of other technology, for example, now everybody has got a smartphone. Fingy technology was just recently launched globally with a hotel in Thailand, in Bangkok. The technology allows you to change the light settings, the aircon, use your room, your phone as the room key. What are your thoughts on such technology, and does that fit into the Ritz-Carlton brand?
I could not see this coming to the Ritz-Carlton in the next couple of years. I think it will not happen soon. However, technology here in Malaysia, and I think in Asia Pacific, we do use the 4G internet, Wi-Fi and wireless internet, 4G. And I think we are one of the few hotels in Asia who use total mobility, where you can take a unit with you and use it in internet. For you can serve your internet in the taxi or in any car, and also call back home through the internet. It was almost free.
Right. I would like to ask you about, in terms of the VIP service, the meet and greet service even that you have at the airport. A lot of people may have not have been to KL. They may be a little bit nervous. Well, how should they get to the property, this, that, the other? How does your VIP meet and greet service at the airport work?
We do actually in the Ritz-Carlton. We have a manager and we have four employees who work for the hotel. We have the train service, the speed train service from the airport to the central. It's owned by the owner of the Ritz-Carlton. Also, we participate, and we the only hotel who provide really that VIP service in Kuala Lumpur International Airport.
Right, and what is it they do? Do they bring you all the way through to the hotel? How does it work?
They wait for you in the gate. They help you take your luggage. They walk with the train. They all sit with you in the train. At the central, they walk with the service, the limo. And then they will send you to the hotel. And at the hotel, at the door, from the general manager to everybody, we'll be welcoming you to the Ritz-Carlton.
So you're pretty much taken, as soon as you get off the plane, all the way to the
Absolutely.
Room, you're taken care of. This sounds perfect. In terms of the internet, because this is another big issue. Now, I know that Ritz-Carlton just recently has signed a contract, I think it was with Bini, with offering the tiered technology. Now, this is a big issue with hotels at the moment. A lot of the Marriott level,
Correct.
If you join the membership, you get free internet now.
Correct.
Some of the budget hotels, it's free internet. Why do you think Ritz-Carlton is going for this tiered approach where the more you use, you have to pay, and less you use, then it's free?
That's correct. We as a company, that was the direction. But I believe, and that's maybe it's a promise, by next year, by 2013, every customer in the Ritz-Carlton, especially here in Kuala Lumpur, will get free internet.
Excellent. Well, do you think that will be the beginning of 2013 or the end?
I think in the beginning could be January 1st, 2013. And not only internet, you will get the 4G internet.
Oh, so something to look forward
Absolutely.
To.
Absolutely.
And that would be unlimited devices, do you think?
Unlimited. You will have the device with you, mobile. You can use it anywhere in Kuala Lumpur when you travel, even to your meeting.
Oh,
you
excellent.
Can use it.
Wow.
Absolutely.
I have to do another interview about
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely.
Now, in terms of online bookings, because obviously that's related to the internet, how much of your business is coming directly through the internet at the moment and through the Ritz-Carlton website?
Online booking is so big for us. 40% of our clients come from online booking.
40%?
40%.
And how do you envisage that growing over the next couple of years?
Between 2011 and 2012, we saw almost 15% growth in the internet booking, online booking.
Right.
And we expect to see another 10 to 15% in the next 3-4 years.
Right. And how is the growth, what sort of growth are you seeing in terms of mobile? Because we have the two avenues, if you like, at the moment. There's the websites, which are traditional laptop and PCs,
Correct.
And there's the mobile. How are you seeing growth? What type of growth are you seeing with the mobile bookings?
I think from that booking, about 15% from the mobile coming in, and in the next 2 years, I could see increase could reach 20% that mobile, because technology, that's where everybody going to.
Right, and which markets are the most tech savvy, if you like? Which ones are coming through that mobile avenue at the moment?
It mostly Europe, US, Singapore, Japan, but you start to see some country, actually like Middle East, they start to use mobile as well.
Right.
Yes. Beside the travel industry, you will see a lot of travel industry. You still have some of the world where they don't like to do the booking themselves. They like to know somebody who arrange all their travel. So you still see it. 80% Middle East still go through travel agency.
Right. I'm glad you mentioned travel agents, because it is a big, big question at the moment. What is the future of a travel agent in your eyes?
I think travel agency will continue to be important for our business. I don't think it will slow down, because as I say to you, guests still exist who like things to be done through somebody else. And also travel agency, don't forget, they're not only leisure, they do a lot of business like MICE and meeting as well, and convention now everywhere in the world.
Right. On the subject of meetings, Ritz-Carlton obviously attends a lot of different trade shows around the world. Which properties will the Ritz-Carlton KL be present at? Which of the travel trade shows will you be
in 2013?
Yes.
I already signed actually for Dubai, the Arab travel market. We already signed for Berlin in Germany. And we will attend also some in China. We do have traveling for business in China. A lot, every 2-3 months we have somebody going to China, but we will be going also for show in Shanghai.
Right, is that the ILTM?
Correct.
The ILTM,
Correct.
Excellent. And in terms of the Malaysia itself, Kuala Lumpur, as we mentioned earlier, you've got Pavilion, which is an amazing shopping center. But if somebody was thinking of going either to Thailand, Singapore, or Bangkok, they wanted to make a decision between one, what would you say to them to persuade them to come to here, to KL, instead of going to Singapore or going to Bangkok like they have been traditionally?
I think cost-wise, I will say to them, compare Singapore, Thailand, and Malaysia, which still is like the most affordable destination in the world. And also, I think the culture, you know, what you experience in Malaysia, you're not gonna experience it somewhere else. If you like to have relaxation, I think Malaysia is a destination. You like shopping, it's a town for everybody, I believe. And you know what? A lot of people will say to you, I wanna enjoy the weather, but food also have a lot to do with your vacation. Malaysia have a lot to offer.
Right. Now, I mentioned you mentioned a lot of things there. One thing you didn't mention was golf. Now, I know that you're a bit of a fan of the game. If somebody was coming here for business and they wanted to have a round of golf, which of the courses around KL would you recommend them try?
We have a lot of good golf courses here. I mean, we have some international courses. Tiger Wood was here last month playing here for CIMB Bank. We have, I will say here in the city, we have a golf course like maybe 10 minutes away from the hotel. You know, we have a relationship with them. We do booking for client also. We have a lot of clients who travel with their golf bag. I will say to somebody in the mountain, in your way to Genting, they have booked dinghy. They have beautiful golf course up there. You don't even feel the heat. Putrajaya, I think the Marriott in IOI, they have a new course, 18 hole, beautiful 18 holes. I just played last week, was it beautiful? So I would recommend something like that.
Right. How much would you want to be expecting to pay at a resort like one of the golf courses?
And that's why coming from Europe, from US, from Asia to Malaysia, I mean, to play golf for 40, 50 USD, that's nothing.
Right.
Comparing to other destinations.
Okay. Now, and of course, not everybody wants to take the golf clubs with them. I presume the courses, they all have clubs to rent
and
everything else.
Including shoes and anything you want.
Excellent.
You can rent the clubs, actually, in Malaysia, which that's something nobody else rented.
Excellent. Well, on that note, I have to say, well, thank you very much indeed for your time today, Mr. Skaf. And
of course,
I wish you and, of course, the Ritz-Carlton and, let's not forget, the JW Marriott
thank
here
you.
In Kuala Lumpur, the best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.